Hello, everyone, and welcome to TPC Game Time, TPCFL. My name is Meter, and I'm joined in the booth today by Commando Slippy. How's it going today, Slippy?
It's going good, Meter. Looking forward to this game.
I am as well. This is going to be one hell of a matchup here today. The reigning Super Bowl champion, Shane's Gaming, taking on the newcomer in Iceman, and he is not playing as his Kansas City Chiefs. We very well may need to restart this game. We are definitely going to restart this game. We don't want to see the Dallas Cowboys out here. Slangel is not playing. We want to see Iceman, the newcomer. We want to see his team, the Kansas City Chiefs. And they will not let this game begin until after the kickoff. So now that we're able to pause, they will reset the game. And what we're going to do is we're going to stick around with you. Slippy, tell me, what did you think of that Super Bowl game? Shane's Gaming arguably upsetting that Whitefish in his debut season, his undefeated regular season. What are your thoughts on that game?
Well, all I can say is, Mida, Shane played incredible. You cannot argue that at all. He put all the skill on the line and proved he was the better player.
That's very true. I mean, that game was absolutely outstanding. I was so happy to be a part of it in the way that I was. The preseason was exceptional. So many people put in a lot of hours to make that happen. And then the game itself, great game. And my hat's off to Shane for coming away after so many seasons in this league with his first TPCFL championship.
Yeah, I mean, he couldn't have asked for more. And I'm sure he was grinning from ear to ear after that game.
He showed the exact same domination, in my opinion, that Whitefish showed all season long.
Mm-hmm. I totally agree on that.
We have started the search here. The game is loading in. What do you expect to see here? I don't know if you've seen Iceman play at all. There's no tape on this guy.
I've not seen anything yet, so today's going to be good for all of us that are tuning in to watch this game on the site today for TPC Sports, because no one's seen him play. This is a good little caption of how he plays for coming into the next season.
Absolutely. I couldn't have said it better myself. This is going to be huge. So hopefully members of the TPCFL are watching us right now. We are restreaming on several platforms: Mixer, Twitch, Facebook. The YouTube one was spotty. It may or may not be up. Regardless, you can find us in all those places and, of course, TPCFootball.com. But for now, we're going to get this game underway with Seattle head coach Shane's Gaming kicking off to Iceman and his Kansas City Chiefs. This one back to about the goal line, being brought out to the 23. No chance to kneel that one as it was kicked to about the 2. He had to take that one out.
Looks like he's going to be a bit of an aggressive player. It's going to be good to see.
And everything that we see today will help paint the picture of how it's going to affect the league coming into this game, especially when you're going against inarguably the best of the best the league has to offer, the reigning Super Bowl champion. Rush attempt right at the middle, stopped for no gain. Go ahead, you were saying?
Sorry, I was going to say, he's also coming into it with an advantage, because no one's seen him play. So if he's been reading back, looking back at previous games, he's seen how we all play. But he's a new player into this league. He's going to have this advantage.
That's an extremely good point. Little pass out to the right side. Wasn't able to drag his foot. His first foot stayed in bounds, but his second stepped right on that white line and caused an incompletion. 3rd and 10 now. Still on the 23. You got 2 out to the left and 1 to the right. Williams just off to the right of the quarterback. Who's the quarterback for the Chiefs? Do you know?
I'm not sure, to be honest.
Let's find that out right now. Now, you are the San Francisco 49ers head coach. Is that correct? Mm-hmm.
That is correct, Nita.
Patrick Mahomes is his starting quarterback.
He's a good quarterback, he is.
And what happened while I was looking away? Looks like a pass over the middle, picked up a first, and a little rush attempt here on first down, picked up 17 yards, jumping over people, pushing through tackles, and falling down at the 49. That is one hell of a push. He is fighting for every yard he's got thus far.
Let's see if Shane's can use his championship defensive tactics against him and hold him off.
Two out to the left side, one in the backfield. Mahomes directly behind the center, takes the snap, dropping back to the 45, thrown out over the middle. This one is swatted out of his hands. What might have been a reception and a first down turns into nothing as Shane does exactly what you're talking about and shows his defensive prowess in knocking the ball loose.
I didn't expect anything different from the reigning champion.
Two out to the right, one way to the left. Williams in the backfield. Mahomes directly behind the center. Tight end off to the right side of the offensive line. Handoff trying to get up to the left side. Someone comes from deep in the backfield and takes him down. But he picks up a good 6 yards there. Mahomes was a rookie last year, last season at least. In the TPCFL this year will be his sophomore season. Last year, last season, the Chiefs went 8-8, 4-2 within their own division, and a 6-6 in their conference. Splitting that one pretty much down the middle.
It makes you wonder what sort of stats are going to come out with at the end of this next season.
Hey, all I can say is that there's a lot of room for improvement for the Chiefs. They have never had a season over 500. They have had two 500 seasons, and every other season has been less than that. A lot of room for growth, a lot of room for somebody to come in and make some things happen. Little pass out to the left side, picks up some good yards. Second and one now on the 24. Handoff getting right up the middle and taken down, but he picks up the first and moves the ball along to the 21-yard line. A good mix of both running and passing so far here today.
Agreed.
And that is so key to a successful team, being able to mix it up, especially against a defensive juggernaut like Shane.
He's just going to have to keep Shane on his toes. That's going to be his only advantage right now.
Calling an audible, mixing it up. Personnel in motion. 5 seconds, shift from the defense. Four, the snap. Dropping back, trying to throw the ball, but he's hit from behind. And Clark comes up with a huge sack. A big loss of 6 on that one. Spots him back at the 27-yard line. Second and 16 now. We'll see how he plays in pressure situations. The snap.
Definitely going to be interesting.
Dropping back. Swallowed whole. He's taken down. Number 90, Reed, coming up with an 8-yard sack.
He's just learning how dangerous the Seahawks defense can be.
You'd think after a sack they would play some cushion defense, try and stop the first down. No, no, no. They came in hard. They took him down and forced a third and 24. This throw over the middle, it's caught. Moves him back into easy field goal range, but wow, 12 yards, and they're still 11 yards shy from a first.
He made some good yardage for his first attempt, though.
and that ends the first. As he is attempting to do the kick, he will have a second chance now at that kick. Wind blowing in the opposite direction as they step back on the field. The kick hooking to the left and back to the right, and it falls within the goalpost. 3 points, Chiefs.
What a good clean kick. Didn't ask for anything more.
And hey, when you're facing the reigning champion to come out, get down the field, and put 3 points on the board, you have the lead. That's a good spot to be in.
Oh, totally. Now we just got to see what his defensive capability is like.
Shane juking between defenders, taking it out of the end zone and down to the 29-yard line on the kickoff. Not bad positioning to start with for the champ, as if he needs another opportunity here, another advantage, if you will. Carson here with a rush, no gain. Langell in chat pointing something out. Kansas City took literally the entire first quarter to put those points on the board. Eating clock. Clock management could be a big part of their game plan. This throw over to the left side. It's swatted out of the air. What a huge defensive play. And I'm getting notification our YouTube stream is now back up and running. And checking it out myself, I can confirm that. Taking off out to the right side on the run, and there is classic Shane. Wilson throwing on the run, picking up 20 yards. Nobody else does it like that.
It makes you wonder, is the pressure of knowing you're going up a champ for your first exhibition game is going to be getting to him as well.
That's a very good point. There's definitely a psychological aspect involved. Little run out to the left side. Loss of one on the run attempt. Last season, rushing for 1,200 total yards. Shane, not a stranger to moving the ball on the ground.
Do you think Iceman has done any research into Shane and how he plays as well?
That's a very good question. I have not asked him myself, but there is a good chance. You know, there's a lot of tape on these guys. Everybody in the league has played on the TPC channel, on Mixer, on Twitch, on YouTube, on Facebook. There's a lot of places to check it out. There's a lot of places to see how their play style is and maybe where some of their gaps may be that they can exploit. Iceman has a decided advantage if they took that advantage. Oh my God, and a beautiful rollout to the left side, throw over the middle. Wilson for 59 total yards here today, 28 on that one. And a giant pickup moves the ball deep in the red zone, the 14-yard line. I formation now, one out wide on either side. The snap dropping back, looking into the end zone, rolling out to the left, throwing into the end zone. This one's caught. Touchdown, Seahawks! A beautiful play to Travis Rudolph. Coming up with 6 points. Extra point pending. And 7 points are on the board in just over 3 minutes. Shane answers Kansas City's three. What does that do to you as a competitor? Being answered in half the time it took you to score with double the points.
It's scary how well Shane plays those.
A couple of rollouts and throwing while on the run. It's just, how do you defend against that?
Especially the way he pops out his quarterback like that, you just can never stop it. Once you see that quarterback moving, you know you've got to get in that backfield and watch it.
I formation, two out to the left. The snap, looking downfield, throwing out to the left side. This one's caught underneath and brought down at the 26 where they started. No such luck on Kansas City's part this time. No gain. Second and 10 now from the 26. One in the backfield. The snap. Backing up. Throwing over the middle. This one's intercepted. Great defensive coverage. A little spin move. Finally getting taken down. Takes us to the two-minute warning. But Seattle with a huge, huge interception there.
Seahawk prowess at his best.
Now that's something we saw in the Super Bowl, in the TPCFL championship game.
Plays like that won in the game. It won in the cup. Let's see if he can win this game the same way.
Handoff out to the left side. A loss of one, or no gain on that one. Three total rushes today for Shane. Minus one total yards. That is a hard stat to see, and honestly, a very rare stat to see. Lateral out to the right side, trying to get some yards, trying to get to the outside, and there's just too many guys. No gain there either. Carson has been shut down.
It looks like using a running game against the Chiefs is going to be a tough one.
It does indeed. They've shut it down up the middle. They shut it down off the ends. They've shut it down on the outside lateral sweep. What do you do to run against this team? Nobody in the backfield from the shotgun. Wilson with two out wide on the left, three on the right. Snap. He's got plenty of time. Thrown over the middle. This one's picked up and swatted out of his hands. Incomplete. Some great defense by Kansas City.
Iceman's just giving up a good fight. Putting up a good fight. Sorry, not giving up. You just can't argue with that defense. That's strong.
It was. Two went nowhere on the run twice in a row. And then to block that pass, that would have been a first down. He had all sorts of time to throw. Just came up big in that situation and forced the 3 points. But even when you win against Shane, he's still putting up points. And a beautiful run back, breaking away from everybody. And my goodness, he takes this one all the way down to the other side of the field, the 49-yard line. I thought he was gone, Slippy.
I thought he was too. Wow.
I formation, handoff, getting up the middle again. The run game very strong from Kansas City. Finding their niche. 15 yards on that one. Through contact, spun off the back of a defender. What a beautiful play.
I'm just looking at the stats here for his running backs, just to see who he's got running with him this year.
Oh my goodness, thread the needle on that one. A throw over the middle. I thought he was going to one guy. The other took it through the hands of the defense, and another great pickup moves him into the red zone, the 18-yard line. Slippy, a touchdown here ties the game going into the second half.
Just, this is what TPC football is. I mean, you can never know if it's going to be a straight win or close as anything. I mean, most of the games we saw last season, up to the last second, they were game changers.
That is so true, and it really shows that Iceman looks like he's going to fit in very, very well in this league. Kansas City calls a timeout on the 8-second mark, standing on the 14-yard line. Looks like they're going to go for a field goal. interesting play. With 8 seconds and two timeouts, they choose to kick the field goal and take what they surely were considering the guaranteed 3 points and leave 4 seconds on the clock for Seattle.
Maybe it was a safety tactic.
And Shane returns it, but is taken down, eating up the remaining 4 seconds and ending the half. Shane has a 4-point lead and is about to get the ball back to start the second half. This one kicked to the edge of the end zone, being brought back to the 10. The 20, there's the 25, and still moving. Does a spin move directly into a defender and is taken down at the 28-yard line. You know, I don't know anybody else in the league that would have kicked a field goal at that situation.
No, but this is what makes it fresh. I mean, everyone seems to be following a set routine. Someone fresh comes in, it's a whole different look on this season. So this could liven it up a bit more.
I love that perspective. Rolling out to the left side. Another great pass over the head of the defense. While running, it's never he stops and sets and turns his shoulders. He just runs, takes off. I swear he jumps off 1 foot and while in the air throws the ball perfectly. No idea how Wilson does it, but Shane's control is impeccable. Another run attempt. Chopped down hard 3 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Absolutely shut down. A total of negative 4 yards in all rushing attempts for the entire day so far for Carson and the Seattle Seahawks.
It's just shocking hearing those stats, especially after seeing what the Seahawks did last season.
Two out to the left, one to the right. Carson in the backfield, the snap. Looking downfield. Not a lot of room to run. Throwing out over the middle. This one's caught. A beautiful stop spin move. Dekes out the first one. But two more come in and take him down. The damage is done. 23 yards on that pass. And a fresh set of downs.
His timing with Wilson is incredible.
It really, really is. Two out to the left side from the shotgun. Everyone else on the offensive line. And the defender who was pressuring just stops. Wilson takes off and is taken down at the 31. A 3-yard rush. The most rushing of anybody on his team today.
Chiefs still making the stop, though. So it's still time for them to stop him all the way. Let's see if they can push him back.
It's a very good point. A stop here is pivotal. Two out to the left. Wilson with one just off to his right side. Hand off to Carson trying to move forward and taken down again behind the line of scrimmage. 6 rushes, negative 5 yards. Have you ever seen this before, Slippy, from Shane?
No, and it just goes to show you, like, maybe Shane's just not, because he's not used to how Iceman plays. But it looks like he's having to keep his toes up. Like, keep on his toes even, sorry. So, this is just incredible.
A little pass over the middle. A big pickup there. 22 more yards. And to be honest.
And there it is.
There have not been a lot of passes or runs this game. Seattle, I think they've only thrown the ball 7 times and have over 100 yards.
It seems they're both playing it very defensively. Maybe it's just because they're new to playing each other, but, I mean, that could be that Shane's trying to psych out and see what the player's like.
And a little throw over the middle, walking in for the touchdown. Seattle widens their lead a little bit more.
What a beautiful play there.
It really was textbook, calm, focused. They're at home. and they're ready to make their mark. 17-6 after the extra point. And Seattle will give the ball back to Kansas City and ask them, what are you going to do? Field goals aren't going to cut it anymore.
No, I think they're going to have to play big now, and we'll see what they do.
Another great run back all the way to the 30 from the edge of his own end zone. He had a lot of room, one guy to get by, and he was gone. Handoff attempt going right up the middle. He has all sorts of room. Amazing blocking. Gets past. Jumps over a diving defender. And he is gone to the 10. Touchdown, Kansas City. And a huge run from Damian Williams. Wow.
Iceman with those runs. Looks like he's going to be something we're going to have to all watch out for.
That was beautiful, Slippy. The jump on the dive tackle.
I know. No one I've seen has managed to time it as beautiful as that, so that's incredible.
That was absolute. You know, sometimes when I'm playing, I'll be honest, I get some moves and I'm like, wow, that was lucky. There was no doubt in my mind that was not luck.
No, it seemed like he planned that. So we'll see what else he can do.
Kansas City answers. I think that was 7 seconds it took them. Maybe
it
nine.
Like that.
Jeez-um. A great run back to the 25-yard line. From in his own end zone, Shane and the Seattle Seahawks will start another drive, still only leading by 4.
There's still plenty of clock for them to come back and win this.
There is. One way out to the left side. Handoff trying to get to the left. And Jones was standing there waiting for him. Carson, 7 rushes, negative 7 yards. He's averaging a negative yard per attempt. Awful.
Can you imagine the upset, the newcomer coming in and beating the champion first off? What's that going to do for Shane in the league?
I'll tell you, coming into this game, no, I couldn't imagine it. Right now? Absolutely. Little pass over the middle, kind of dangerous. Looks like Kansas City could have picked that one off, but instead, a pick up a 16 and a first down. One in the backfield, everyone else on the line. The snap, handoff, trying to get out to the outside, and he does, and he's tripped up at the bootlaces. The first positive run of the night, 2 yards for the halfback.
I don't know about you, Mida.
Go ahead.
But are you seeing a different team here from what we just seen from the first half?
In like, one of them specifically?
Like in Kansas City, their stats, the way they were playing in the first one was very defensively, but now they're like all over Seahawks.
They are a huge hit there as he's catching the ball, knocks it loose. There's another incompletion. I mean, most times we were seeing their defense wake up when Seattle was in the red zone. Now they're waking up on the 40-yard line and stopping the Seahawks' drives cold.
I just wasn't expected to see Kansas City this good. I mean, I know someone new coming into the league, you just don't know what to expect, but like, you, when you see the champs going up against them, you just automatically in your head think, right, the champs are going to be all over this. This is just showing you what TPC is.
I could not have said it better myself as we close out the third. On Carson running out, or on Wilson running out to the left side, way out of the pocket, throwing off balance and hitting his mark again for a 21-yard pickup. Seattle resets their downs, and we will reset the clock for the final time. 6 minutes left in this one. Lateral out to the right side. He has some room, some good blocking, getting out to the sidelines finally. Carson back into the positives for the day. 12 yards on that sweep. Two out to the right side, one in the backfield. Strong offensive line trailing off to the left side. Handoff, trying to get out to the left side and absolutely demolished. Four Chiefs take them down. A familiar sight today, a loss of two on the run attempt by Seattle. Second and 12 now, on the 28-yard line, Seattle. Steps up to the line, one out to the left, two to the right. A shift from the defense at the last second. Rolling out to the right is Shane, throwing out. He's hit, but he holds on to the ball and moves it on down to the 9-yard line. A 20-yard pickup sets him deep in the red zone. In fact, we're there, folks. We're in the red hot zone. 9-yard line. Looking at that end zone. Nowhere else to go but into the score zone. Handoff. Trying to get up the middle. Pushing forward for 4 yards. Moving the ball to the 5. Shane is just so deadly in the red zone.
The worst part to be.
Dangerous, dangerous part of the field to be in right now for the Seahawks. Kansas City has all their defensive men within 15 yards of the quarterback at any time. The snap. Defense coming in fast and sacks him way behind the line of scrimmage, bringing him all the way back to the 10. That's a loss of 5. Seattle has got 2 sacks on Kansas City, and Kansas City returning the favor with one of their own here today. Go, go, go. One out wide on either side, the snap. Dropping back, moving around in the pocket, pulling out to the right. This one swatted out of the air. And this, Lippy, could be an absolute game changer, stopping them deep in the red zone, stopping them on the 10-yard line and forcing a kick to keep this game within 7 points. Slippy. This is what TPC is all about.
I know, I just don't know what to say. I mean, looking at this, it's like you just, it's shocking how well his defense is changing it up each time.
Brought out from in just on the edge of the end zone. No chance to kneel it from the 2-yard line, has to take it out. Is hit very hard and low and taken down at the 25-yard line. Here we go, folks. Let's reset this. Here's what we're looking at. From the 25-yard line, the Kansas City Chiefs have 2 timeouts and trail by 7 points, 1 touchdown with 2:49 left in the game. Let's see what they do here. Waiting, throwing out over the middle. This one swatted out of the air. Dangerous throw. Any mistakes here are going to have huge implications on the rest of this game.
Yes, you couldn't ask for more in a game like this, though. The pressure, high stakes, all at once.
The Chiefs with a handoff, trying to get right up the middle and pushing forward pretty well to the 31-yard line. That's a 6-yard pickup and sets them up in a 3rd and 4 situation. This is a huge 3rd down opportunity. Two out to the left, one to the right. Williams just off to the right of Mahomes in the shotgun situation. Man in motion from the right side of the line. Over to the left, the snap. Handoff again, getting up to the first down line. And that there it is, the two-minute warning and a fresh set of downs for Kansas City. Oh, my goodness, this one is going to be a bumpy ride all the way to the end.
Going back to what Landry was saying about clock management with the Chiefs, the Chiefs have some incredible time management, and it looks like this is their plan here.
Little throw over to the left side. This one's picked up, getting some good blocking, diving through everybody, and moving the ball all the way to the 46-yard line. Not in any hurry here. Kansas City resets their downs on an 18-yard pickup. It moves the ball to the opponent's side of the field. Two take off to the right side, one to the left. Williams just off to the left side of Mahomes. Calling an audible, mixing it up, moving everybody over to the left side of the field. Now three out wide to the left. The snap, handoff, fake, looking downfield, throwing. This one is swatted out of the air into the hands of Watkins, who pushes forward through a tackle and ends up picking up some big yards. What in the heck just happened?
I've seen nothing like that before.
That was wild. Swatted out of the air into the hands of a different receiver who's hit way back almost at the line of scrimmage and bounces off of the hit to stumble forward for a pickup of 8. Unheard of. Second and somehow 2 now. Less than a minute left to play here in the game. 3 out to the right, 1 to the left. The snap dropping way back, throwing out short over the middle. This one's caught. Williams yet again picking up some good yards, moving the ball down to the 28-yard line. Hurry up, offense on the field. Four on the right side now. One out to the left. The snap looking downfield. Thrown out to the right side onto the sidelines, and this one is caught, and he steps out of bounds, stopping the clock dead at 32 seconds in the red hot zone, the 9-yard line. I'm so used to it being on the 6, but oh my God, Slippy.
This is just TPC football, mate. That's all I can say.
TPC football, mate. I am almost speechless here. This is unbelievable. The snap standing at the 15, looking, throwing out to the left side. This one's caught through a defender, stepping out of bounds at the 5-yard line. It looks like he had some room, but the momentum took him out of bounds. He made the catch, though. Move the ball 5 yards closer. Second and goal.
What's he going to do here, Mita? What is he going
to
do?
I have no idea, but I can't wait to find out. 27 seconds on the clock from the shotgun. Everyone is on the line. 2 out wide on either side. The snap looking into the end zone. Throwing it. That's caught. Touchdown, Kansas City. Woo! What is he going to do in this situation? Does he tie the game? Does he go for it all?
He's tying it.
And the field goal is up, and it's good. So clean, so professional. This is TPC Football. If you haven't dropped a subscribe, do it right now. This is every single game in this league, and it is intense. From the 25-yard line as the kickoff is kicked well through the end zone, Seattle will start their drive 24 seconds on the clock. All 3 of their timeouts, they might as well have an entire quarter to play with. Rolling out to the right side, thrown over the middle. This one's picked up. Huge, huge yardage there. Timeout immediately from Seattle, stopping the clock at 16 seconds and moving the ball to their own 47-yard line.
This is just where the Seahawks are going to come out now, I think. We've seen this before. Shane's managed to pull something out of the bag. He's got 16 seconds. Let's see if he can do it.
No matter what happens in this game, Slippy, how impressed are you with the Kansas City Chiefs?
I'm super impressed, and it looks like we're going to have a...
Oh, my God, an interception! What a huge play! He's taking down the clock's dead at 10, but Murray coming up with a huge interception!
This game has got me edging closer and closer to the screen. If I get any closer, I'm going to be on the field, but wow.
I'm not in my seat anymore. I am standing, Slippy. I can't handle this. Every person in this stadium is on their feet screaming for their Seattle team to play some defense here. They got to get in field goal range. They got 2 timeouts and 10 seconds to make it happen. Throwing this one over the middle, it's caught. And he's taken down. The clock stopped at 3 seconds on the opponent's 49-yard line. I don't think they can kick the field goal here. It's just too far.
Ooh, timeout.
The final play of regulation, throwing it deep. This one is swatted out of the air. What a huge play. And we are going to overtime.
What can you say, Mida? His first game in the TPC and he's already in an overtime match.
And wow. This isn't even an official game. This is a friendly. This is, though it's sanctioned by the TPCFL, it's on the network, it's called by the broadcasters. This does not go in the stat books. This is all for pride, and both of these teams have earned the respect of every member of the TPCFL locker room.
I mean, he's making a statement coming in the door like this. It's not like, oh, I'm new to the game. He's come in, guns blazing. He's made a statement.
An overtime match against the defending TPCFL champion, the 5-season veteran. Throw over the middle. This one's caught. And Shane moves the ball to the 43. Overtime match. In the preseason game. Wow.
I don't even know who's going to win this game now. It is completely up in the air.
Lateral out to the right side, trying to get there. Can't get quite to the sidelines. Picks up a couple of yards. Carson, 12 rushes, 11 yards gained. Less than a yard per attempt for the Seahawks today. And I might argue they're lucky to have any rushing yards, given the way they rushed today. They've seen more negative than positive. I think they had one big run for like 12 yards that gave them almost everything they have.
Yeah, that pretty much was it.
Rolling out to the left side, thrown from the 40-yard line. This one's caught, getting to the other 40. Ducking, diving, juking, getting past people, and moving the ball down to the 21-yard line. Some great moves from the Seattle receiver to keep that ball moving.
It makes you wonder what Shane sees when he's running like that, because I've attempted it with my team and I could never see the openings. Shane hits it more 9 times out of 10.
Such patience, such a great QBI. Carson way behind Wilson, who's directly behind the center. Everyone else on the offensive line evenly spread out. The snap, handoff, getting out to the left side, picking up some yards here. A beautiful spin move nets him the first down in what should have been a tackle well behind the first down line. A beautiful play. 11 yards gain there. And Seattle is looking to end this one in the opening drive of overtime. 2 out to the left, 1 to the right, 2 in the backfield. Shift from the defense. The snap, looking downfield. Taken off to the right side, throwing, and this one's intercepted again. He's got all sorts of room to run. Can anybody catch him? The 30, the 40. Cutting back in and taken down at the 47. Oh, my goodness. And a field goal now will end the game. Kansas City can walk away with a huge victory in Seattle.
this game is just crazy. It's amazing.
Handoff, getting out to the left side. He has some blocking, getting to the sideline. He's gone and steps out of bounds at the 31 as a defender comes in. A 23-yard pickup on the counter. Oh, my goodness. Kansas City stands on the 31-yard line. 3:20 left here in overtime. All they need is a field goal. Handoff attempt again, cutting back over to the right side of the center and being taken down at the 28. That's another 3 yards for Kansas City. The clock pretty much irrelevant at the moment. Two out to the right, one to the left. Mahomes in the shotgun. The snap, handoff. Another run attempt up the middle, this time for a loss of one. The counter didn't work that time as Seattle was expecting a run.
Both teams have got a lot to say after a game like this. You can't argue from either side the way they've both played. This has been a really good game.
I could not have said that better myself. Dropping way back to the 40. Thrown out over the middle, over the end of the defender. This one's caught. Hill pulling that one in and bringing it down to the 14-yard line. A 15-yard pickup. And Kansas City easily in field goal range now. Looks like they're going to run another play anyway. I formation handoff. Pushing up the middle. Moving it 2 yards further. Down the field to the 12.
He's chewing the clock up. Look how much time he's used up in this one run.
He is. The clock irrelevant in overtime other than you don't want it to hit zero before you put points on the board. But regardless, he's using it effectively all the same. Handoff again trying up the middle. Picks up a single yard. Third and 7 now from the 11-yard line. Mahomes in the shotgun, one just to his right. Everyone else on the offensive line. The handoff again, pushing into a defender and being taken down at the 10. Picking up a single yard 3 times in a row. And he is going to kick the field goal. I cannot handle what's about to happen, Slippy.
It's good.
Right down the middle. And the Kansas City Chiefs, the rookie Iceman, pulls up the upset on the reigning Super Bowl champion Shane's Gaming and the Seattle Seahawks at home in overtime.
What a way to come into the TPC.
I'll tell you what, anybody who thought that they were going to steamroll over the Kansas City Chiefs the way they've seen for the past 5 seasons has shut their mouth and is now going to be studying a whole lot of Chiefs tape in preparation for any battle against them as they prove that they are a competitor in this league and maybe heading all the way to the TPCFL Championship game. Shane's Gaming in a huge upset, taking a loss in overtime. What a game.
Just makes you wonder, though, if those two face each other in the next season, how it will go down. Will it be as close as this, or will Shane come back more aggressive now? Like, I've just lost, now I've got a point to prove being the champ.
Wow. That was an absolutely amazing game. I don't believe we'll be doing an interview, but let me actually just reach out and see. Bear with me just a moment. right. We are about to be joined by Iceman. In just a moment, if anybody in chat has anything they want to ask him, drop it in now, and we will ask. Iceman Illest, head coach of the Chiefs, walking away with an overtime field goal victory in Seattle against the reigning TPCFL champion. What an introduction to the league. Welcome to your post-game interview. How are you feeling right now?
Nervous. That was nerve-wracking for me.
That was absolutely amazing to call, to watch. Welcome to the league. I think you're going to fit in just fine.
Appreciate it. I'm glad to be here. You know, first game exhibition. It was an amazing game to play. A lot of learning experiences of how he does things. I have to see why he's the champ, because he makes plays.
He is very good at what he does, but, I mean, you shut down his run game. He had negative yards for most of the game until the fourth when he finally got a couple of runs in, but you absolutely shut him down in the running game. I think that played a huge role in your victory.
It did. It did. I adjusted accordingly. I had a brief overlay or a little one-on-one with the Kansas City defense, so I know how to work the defense pretty okay, I can say, so far.
There were some people in chat during the game wondering if you had watched any tape, any previous games that Shane had played. Had you spent any time in the tape?
No, I have not watched no gameplays, no tape of anybody's game.
Interesting. Well, I'll tell you what, that game is going to be studied by a lot of people to see how the heck are we going to go against the Kansas City Chiefs. We do have some questions for chat from chat. Bama Shucks wants to know, what's it like to show the entire TPCFL how Kansas City gets it done?
It feels good. It makes a somewhat statement that Kansas City might make a comeback, make the champion squad.
Absolutely. I mean, this is unprecedented. Not to discredit you, but I mean, you were going against the best our league has to offer. The reigning champion, a 5-season competitor, a veteran, and you upset him in overtime. That is amazing. And I think adding you into this league is going to greatly increase the competitiveness that this league has to offer. I think you are an absolutely amazing asset to this league. Welcome to the TPCFL.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here, and I can't wait to meet everybody else.
Did you say meet or beat?
Meet.
Well, fair enough. Slippy, were there any questions you had that you wanted to ask?
There was one, but first of all, congratulations for your first win against the champions. My question was, did you have any pressure coming into this game, knowing full well they were the champion of last season?
It was some pressure. I was a bit nervous, shaky a little bit, because he's a champion. And so it just got into my skin, started jittering once we got the ball rolling, and I threw a couple picks. I got kind of shut down a lot, but I regained my composure, and I just played my game the best I know.
Well, you played incredible.
Great game. So happy to have you here. We are going to shut down the stream, but man, I am pumped for some TPC football coming into this. Thank you so much for playing this preseason game today, Iceman. Give people a little taste of what to expect from Kansas City. Statistically, in the past 5 years, Kansas City's best season was last season, and they went 500, 8-for-8. I'm going to be honest, I don't see that happening ever again for Kansas City, as long as you're the coach.
No, sir. I think this season, as me as the new owner, I think Kansas City is going to go a long way.
I love to hear that, and I have to agree. Your clock management was on point. The owner of the league is in chat, Langell. He says, your clock management is the top tier in the league. And to be honest,
it's all about
Langell's clock management is really good. So from him, that is huge.
Thank you. It's all about clock management. You gotta can't just rush into plays. You gotta look and observe how the defense or the offense is going about it.
Mm-hmm. Well, once again, congratulations. We are gonna sign off here. Thank you, Slippy, so much for calling this game with me here today. Outstanding job.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.
My name's Ben Meter. This is TPC Football. Head on over to TPCFootball.com to find out all sorts of stats and figures and see what's going on, who controls what team, what are the scores of games, and when to expect the next game. We're also on Twitter, TPCFL, and Mixer, TPC Sports. We're now streaming on YouTube, Twitch, and Facebook as well, so wherever you're watching, make sure you hit that subscribe button to tune in for more games. My name's Ben Meter. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and I hope you all have an outstanding rest of your night.